Hey, what's up, you guys? Today, I'm going to get into a step-by-step guide on how to make a whole website on Bluehost. Bluehost is super easy and simple to use for beginners, and I'll be showing you exactly how. All right, guys, let's jump right into the video. Once you've clicked the link in my description, it'll take you to Bluehost's website. Go ahead and click on the Get Started and choose your preferred plan. So you can go ahead with their basic plan, which allows you to have one website, or any of the other plans that let you make an unlimited amount of websites. If you're a beginner, I'd personally recommend the Choice Plus plan since you have the freedom of making more than one website, and it's the most worth it at its price. Of course, the basic plan is also a good deal if you're just searching for a platform for one main website and don't intend on using it extensively. Next, you'll be asked to create a domain name. This is what users will type in when looking up your website, so try to make it easy, short, and catchy. Bluehost isn't going to make you pay extra fees for this. So once you've created your account, go ahead and refresh your page to log in with your new username and password. You can see I've already made a page called Food for Foodies. So once you're on this page, go ahead and press Log In to WordPress. I'm going to press View Sites, which will take me to the website I have so far. But as you can see, WordPress and Bluehost have really helped with filling in blank spaces and giving my website a pretty nice theme. So they've guided me on what customers generally would want to see when opening a website. Again, none of these images I've added. Just based on the information I've plugged in, which is literally just the name, they've created this whole theme for me. So, going back to the top, it's giving me a chance to add a brief description of my website, what I offer to consumers, and the point of the platform, really. Here, customers can click on the Read More icon, which gives them the chance to see a more in-depth description of the website. Then, it gives me a chance to feature other things on my website, like pictures, little bits of information, and other stuff as well. Here, it allows you to input your business hours if you have any, and your contact info, which is super important for people to contact you and so on. They also give your customers a chance to subscribe to a newsletter if you have one. So what even surprised me is that if we scroll up here, you can see they even made a whole menu for us. So I didn't input any of this information. I simply made the title, chose a template, and they've given me example names of dishes and their prices. If we go to the About page here, I can input more information any customers may want to know. Like maybe why this company has been established, why the customer should choose my product as opposed to others, and just general information as well. As you can see, there is also a photo they added for me, and I can always switch it out with other photos of my own. So if we press on Contact here, you can see that it gives the consumer the chance to contact us directly by putting in their own information and then any inquiries they might have. Also, they have the option to call if you've added a reachable phone number. All right, so this is great, but I want to edit my page. To edit it, I'm going to go ahead and press on Edit Page that's up here, and now you can see I can edit. Bluehost is so helpful to beginners, it'll even give you an analysis on things like readability or the search engine optimization, or SEO for short. So you definitely want to try to consciously get it to a good or great analysis. So right now my readability analysis is good, but it's letting me know that my SEO analysis needs some work. So you can go ahead and press Edit in Website Builder now. It'll take you to this page where you can edit everything you want to. Up here, I can choose which page I want to edit first. I'm going to make my business hours the weekdays and weekends will be off. So I'm pretty happy with the contact page like that. Let's go to the home page since that's the first thing my customers will see. Now, as you can see, it's giving me different options for a layout. I'm just going to go through them and find the one that I like. So this one works. Now I'm going to hit save to make sure I don't lose any of my changes. If I press on image here, I can replace the featured photo. You can search up stock images or even download one on your own. I'm going to search up a stock image. I like these pancakes, so let's go with that. I'm also going to replace this burger with a better looking burger. And this one looks pretty good. I can change the color scheme and also choose an animation. But I think for now this is good. So let's see how this would look if we're using a phone or a tablet. You can also edit here too. Now let's switch our about to something a bit more interesting. Let's find a better layout. I can manipulate the image, title buttons, subs, and description here. We can also add an address here. Let's choose a better layout. I like this one. It's simple. Let's press save and preview our changes. Let's check out what we did from a smartphone user's perspective. All right, let's go over our changes. Press preview at the top right corner of your screen. Now we have our smartphone preview. We're at the home, so let's scroll down. Here's the animation we chose and our business hours. Let's go to the about page. It's also been updated. Here, don't forget to add your address. Finally, let's check out contact. And now we can go to the desktop version. Not everything is complete, but they all follow the same main ideas. Here is the animation we added earlier. Here are our business hours. Here's the menu, like on the phone. Our about is also updated. And finally, our contact page is updated too. Once you've inputted all the desired info, just press publish and you're good to go. And now my site is live. It's just that easy. Anyways, guys, that's all for today's video. I really hope you liked it. It's a little bit of a longer video. Let me know what you think about it. If there are any other tutorials or video ideas you have, be sure to leave them in the comment section below. Anyway, so don't forget to click the link in my description to get started on your website at a super discounted price. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to give the video a like and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you in the next one.